Microsoft is about to release a new version of Windows, Windows 8. You may have already heard some buzz about it, and you might have heard some people say that it's confusing or hard to use, while other people say that they really like the new features. So we wanted to give you a sneak peek to help you decide whether or not you should upgrade. Windows 8 offers a completely new computing experience. If you've used Windows before, the first thing you'll notice is it looks totally different. Microsoft has moved a lot of things around, and it may take you a while to figure out how to do even the most basic tasks, like finding your files or switching to a different program. One reason why they've made so many changes is they wanted Windows 8 to run on tablets, as well as desktops and laptops. There are actually two different views in Windows 8. Right now we're looking at the start screen. The other view is the desktop, which looks very similar to earlier versions of Windows, except the start button has been removed. Chances are you'll use both of these views for different tasks, and you'll get used to switching back and forth. Let's take a look at the start screen. You can click on an app to open it. Now, unlike earlier versions of Windows, apps don't open in a window. They fill the entire screen. But if you prefer multitasking, you can drag the app to the side and then open a second app. To close them, you can drag them down and you'll go back to the start screen. Many apps use active tiles, which let you see information on the tile itself without even clicking on it. That means you can see the weather, news headlines, and more right from your start screen. To get the most out of Windows 8, you'll want to go to live.com to create a free Microsoft account if you don't already have one. This will let you use Microsoft's online services. For example, you can use SkyDrive to store your documents, photos, and other files in the cloud. You can also store your calendar, contacts, and more online. Why is this important for Windows 8? Well, you can log in with your Microsoft account, and it will automatically pull your calendar, email, photos, and more, so you can access them easily from your start screen. The coolest part of this is that you can log into any computer that has Windows 8, and all of your settings and your SkyDrive files will be there. Now, if you're wondering where all of your old files and folders are, don't worry. You can still get to them by going to the desktop and navigating to the folder that you want. And many of your existing programs will still run from the desktop view, although you should do some research to find out whether they are Windows 8 compatible. As you can see, there are a lot of changes to the new Windows. If you're not comfortable relearning how to use your computer, then you may want to stick with your current version for now. But if you're really into new technology and you like the idea of storing your files in the cloud, chances are you'll feel right at home in Windows 8.